एवरीवन, वेलकम टू आवर चैनल ऑफ नागेश करसगी ऑर्किड स्कूल। माय नेम इज काजल कुलकर्णी एंड आई एम गोइंग टू टीच ग्रेड 5 एसएसटी। नाउ इन आवर प्रीवियस रिकॉर्डिंग्स और इन आवर प्रीवियस सेशंस वी हैड सीन ऑल अबाउट द वर्ल्ड वॉर्स। यस, वर्ल्ड वॉर मीन्स व्हाट? इट इज द वॉर बिटवीन मेनी कंट्रीज। मेनी कंट्रीज आर पुल्ड, they are means even though if the country is not willing to fight or they are not willing to have the war, but still forcefully they are pulled for the war. And in this way World War I occurred, and then later on World War II also means it also took place. And in that many soldiers, many people had to give away their lives. After the war, those countries were really suffering very badly. They were having lack of food, lack of you can say everything. They were not having good source. So then the countries which were financially very strong, they came together and they formed one organization, and that was called as United Nations. Okay. So in this United Nations they all came together and then decided for the better conditions of all the countries. Then I told that in that United Nations there are total 15 country members, right? All the country members at present, today's day, 193 countries are the members of United Nations. So now what is the main aim of this United Nation? The main aim is that they have to, if there are any war means any chances of war, so these United Nations, these countries, they meet together and try to solve away their problem. Then we had means to maintain the international peace among themselves. Then if suppose there were any chances, then they used to send the army, and those army force were called as peacekeeping force. Then we had to develop friendly relation among the two countries. The third was to encourage respect to the people who were in that country. They should be given respect and they should be respected by each other. So how that friendly relation or how that good climate will be done among themselves? So they used to take care of all this. Then if suppose there are any economic or social problems, like if a rich country, a very rich country, can try to help a poor country so that it can try to come up and in the path of developing country. And later on, after many years and many efforts, they can also turn to a developed country. See, we say India is a developing country. India is not a developed country. It is still developing country. Why? Because even today, when we say our country is developed, when there are good facilities, when we have good roadways. Now we can see in Cholapur itself that all the roads are dug, right? They all digged everywhere. So if the roads, if everything is fine, we are getting good facilities, people are, they don't have to move from one place to another for the sake of job. If we are really stable, then we can say that we are a developed country. If each and every person of our country is educated, we can say that our country is developed country. So we are still developing. So the weaker ones are helped by the richer ones. Then in case if suppose there are any chances of, now at present we are having corona, so the countries, they help each other. If suppose one country finds out the vaccination for this, they will definitely help the other country and share that vaccine. Okay, so in that way they help each other. Then what were the principles? Means principles of United Nations, that all the country members, whichever country were the member, it may be very rich country, it may be very poor country, they are the member of the United Nations, they should be treated equally. They are having equal, equal rights to present their views. Then all the country members, they have to follow the charter of the rules and regulations which were passed by the United Nations. So they had to follow all those charter. Then the countries must settle down whatever problems peacefully, sitting together and do solve the problem peacefully, no fights. And whatever the domestic affairs were there, were solved by the government of that country. Then we had the structures, the organs, right? As I told students that 15 members, yes, we had stopped there, that 15 members are the members of United Nations. Out of those, 5 are the permanent members. Which are those 5 nations? United States of America, United Kingdom, China, France and Russia. These 5 are the permanent members. The remaining 10 are elected every 2 years, right? And all these members, all the other member countries, they have the right to vote, but 1 vote of each country. Then we had General Assembly. Now this General Assembly was nothing but it was a 193 country members form General Assembly. Whatever problems they do have their meeting, and in that meeting, once in a year they had their meeting, and in that meeting they used to discuss about the points, and all the points came together, the decision was taken on the basis of voting. Higher votes, that decision was taken. Then was Secretary Council. Now the Secretary Council has the full right to take the decision. Whatever decision is taken in this Secretary Council, and the countries have to follow it. Then we had seen the Secretariat. Now who is the Secretariat? Antonio Guterres is the Secretary of United Nations. Okay, so he is the one who looks after the day-to-day work of the United Nations, and he is elected for 5 years. He was elected in the year 2017. Okay, then we had the Economic and Social Council. So now in this we had different agencies. As I told, we had stopped there. Social, we had a special agencies who looked after everything. Now if we talk about the world, it is means such a huge that one person cannot take care of everything. So the special agencies were selected. Now in this agencies, if I say one agency is selected, okay, and it is located in America, will that agency be able to take care of the all the countries or all the country members? No, it is not possible. So in each and every country, one agency was selected. Now we will see that we had stopped at United Nations Children's Fund, that is UNICEF. So we will start with that. United Nations Children's Fund, that is UNICEF. You all must have heard about this, students, UNICEF. A lot of ad come on the television also regarding this UNICEF. Now what this UNICEF is doing, what exactly the work this UNICEF is given. So UNICEF is responsible for the welfare of children all over the world. It conducts programs especially in developing countries to ensure that the food, health and educational needs of children are met. Now see students, that even our government focuses lot on children. Why? because we say that the children, the present, what the children you are, you all children are the future of the country. Why you are called the future of the country? Because when we all are not in this world, you children means you, when you grow up, you are going to do something for the nation, and out of you only the means you will become something and you will do something for the betterment of the country. So you are the future of the country. If the children are not given proper food, if they are not given proper nourishment, if they are not given proper education, if their health is not good, so what will happen? Definitely the children's, when a child is eating a good quality of food, what happens? The child becomes very active, right? So when a child is very active, he or she can do whatever they want to do and achieve success, right? So this UNICEF is responsible to take care of the food, then health and education of the children in the developing countries. Now you all must have heard about the schools, the government schools, wherein they are provided food, right? They are given lunch. In some places, they are given milk. Even those students, to call those students to school so that they can be educated. See, because they are very poor, the parents are unable to send them to school. So what the government has started, the government says that because they are, means the parents take them for work. So whatever money is earned, they can use that, utilize that money in their daily, means root, every day what they need to survive. So the children are not sent to school for that reason. So government has started that those children who daily attend the school, some amount is deposited in their account. So the account is being created so that the amount is deposited, and that amount the parents can use for their day-to-day utility, and the children are sent to the school. So this is the duty of the UNICEF, that the students who are, means in government school, because they even don't have good food, so they are given food, milk, eggs, everything, okay, in the government schools. So why is that so? So that even those children get a chance to educate, means they also can be educated, they also get a chance to become literate, okay. And if each and every person of the country is educated, then definitely there are full chance for a country to become to a developed nation. So this UNICEF looks after the food, health and education needs of the children. Okay, this UNICEF works mostly in the rural areas, villages. Okay, then we have the United Nations Educational, Scientific and Cultural Organization. Students, you have to remember this full form. What is the full form of UNICEF? UNI means United Nations Children's Fund. CEF. CEF means Children's Fund. UNI means United Nations Children's Fund. It is in short called as UNICEF. Then we have United Nations Educational, Scientific and Cultural Organization, which is called as UNESCO. Now what is the work of this UNESCO? UNESCO was established by the UN in 1946. Its aim is to encourage nations to work together in the areas of education, science and culture. The UNESCO educates people about health and farming methods, spreading scientific knowledge, teacher training and cultural exchange of students and teachers between countries. Now see what is the UNESCO's role. Again, UNESCO plays a very important role, as it helps the farmers in guiding, means they guide the farmers in case of agriculture, okay, farming, how to use new methods of farming. So farming methods are taught to the farmers. They look after the education and science and culture. Science, now when we talk about science, in science we say that if suppose there are very, means in India we are now facing so much problem, okay, even India is trying to find out the vaccine for corona, right? So if suppose we are not having any scientists, we are not having any doctors here, so what will happen? What will happen? No doctors, no scientists, then the people will here suffer a lot and the death rate will be very high, right? So this UNESCO looks after all this, that there should be balance, education, science and culture. And so the UNESCO educates the people in the form farming. Now see, when we talk about farming students, they help the farmers in guiding new farming technologies. If the farmer is working, then what will happen? The cultivate, whatever is the produced, whatever the farm means, whatever food grains are produced from that farm, it will be in a huge quantity, right? With less efforts, huge quantity. So UNICEF takes care of this. If there is a good quality food crops are growing in the nation, what will happen? The people will get good food to eat, right? If there is good food, then only the people will, if there are good crops, then only the people can get good food to eat. Similarly, if there are good teachers, then only the students can be educated. So the UNICEF also plays the role in training the teachers. There are, every time we find new technologies, new teaching methods, new methods that how things can be done easy. So the UNICEF looks after, sorry, the UNESCO looks after the teaching training also. And the cultural exchange of students and teachers between countries, that is, we say that even students, you all must have seen the international fairs, right? So wherein the students and teachers are given chance to explore their self, means they are given chance that you can show off your talent. So this is the responsibility of UNESCO. Next is Food and Agriculture Organization, that is FAO. Now what is the main aim of this FAO? The main aim of FAO is freedom from hunger. That is, nobody should remain hungry. Nobody should have a, means they should not sleep hungry, empty stomach. Okay. Everyone should get good quality food and everyone should get food to satisfy their hunger. Okay. So, the main aim of FAO is freedom from hunger for every human in the world. It helps nation to increase food production. It provides them with help in getting better seeds, controlling crops and animal diseases, improving irrigation, conserving soil and forest, etc. It warns of food shortages and arranges food for people suffering during such times. Now, when suppose what this FAO is doing, its main aim is that nobody should remain hungry. All should get food. In the world, everyone should have food. Nobody should remain hungry. So, it helps the nation to increase the production of the crop, to get the good, better seeds. If the seeds are not of good quality, then the crops will be of, means they are also of very low quality. Controlling the crops and animal diseases. Animals also are very important for means to conserve, we should conserve animals also, because they also play a very, it should be stable, right? More human beings and no animals, no use, all should be to a stability. So animals, disease, to improve, to take care of them, and improving irrigation means cropping, means farming, okay, and conserving the soil. The soil, as we use some fertilizers, so what are useful for the plants, that is shown, or that is guided in FAO. Then it also warns if there is shortage of food in any of the nation, and it helps to send those in those nations where there is deficiency or in shortage of food. Okay, see here, the American troops in Iraq. Next, International Labour Organization, ILO. The main aim of the ILO is to improve the working conditions and living standards of the working class. So what is the main aim now here? That human, a man, if he is working any somewhere, then he should be not treated badly. Some standard, means some living standard should be there of that working person. So the ILO, that is International Labour Organization, looks after the working conditions. Achievements of the United Nations. Now, what are the achievements? What they have achieved after forming the United Nations, what they have achieved? The United Nations had tried to prevent tensions or war between countries. It has been largely successful in its efforts. Wars between India and Pakistan, Iran and Iraq, Israel and Palestine, North and South Korea, and many others were not allowed to grow bigger, mainly because of the efforts of the United Nations. Now this says, what are the achievements? Yes, definitely we have seen that now there are no wars, like it has a very, to some means it has reduced a lot. So the whatever they have efforts, whatever efforts they have put forth, are now seen successful, largely successful. Why? Because the wars, we have always seen that there is a tension between India and Pakistan borders every time, yes or no? So similarly, many other countries like Iran and Iraq, Israel and Palestine, North and South Korea, many other countries. So these have allowed to stop the growing of bigger war, turning into some bigger war. This is just because of the efforts of the United Nations. The UN has also played an important part in arms control, especially in preventing the use of nuclear weapons. Now students, you all must have heard about this. We always see on news that there is some tension in between India and Pakistan near the border. So we just get hyper and we say that why don't they start a fight? Why don't they just start firing them? There is a limit even in that. The UN, they have decided that how much of the nuclear weapons a country can have. Okay, so there is a bar, there is a restriction to have the nuclear weapons also, and to some extent, means to a very we can say to very few extent, we should have the arms and ammunitions, whatever is required for the safety. So the UN has been very successful in its fight against poverty, disease and illiteracy. It has also achieved success in improving cultural cooperation among countries. Yes, definitely we have seen that many countries, now we have already seen that many countries are in support of India, right? So this, due to this UN, United Nations, it has become very successful, and it has reduced the illiteracy. People are now educating, people are sending. Earlier the girls were not sent to school. Now even a girl child is sent to school, and even a girl child is having same rights. However, people in the developing world feel that the UN does not understand the problems of the developing nations very well and is therefore unable to solve their problems. It could not prevent the invasion of Iraq by American led armed. As I showed this image, students, that was of the American troops in Iraq. Why they are sent? As these are the peacekeeping force, okay? Nor put an end to the war in Darfur, Sudan. Some people have also questioned the veto power enjoyed by the 5 permanent members of the nation. Now, as I said, that 5 countries are the members of the United Nations. Which are those 5 countries? United States of America, United Kingdom, Russia, France, and China. These 5 are having the veto power. Veto power means they are having all the rights. They can take whatever decision they have taken. The remaining country members have to follow the rules what they have passed. Okay. So many countries are questioning that why those such powers are being enjoyed by only those 5 countries. Why, students, why do you think that why those 5 powers are enjoyed by those 5 countries? Yes, I had earlier explained it, that these 5 countries are really a very rich country. They are very rich countries. So they are having all the powers in their hand. We are still developing. So now what this passage is telling, that the country feels, the developing country, the people of that country are feeling that what does those countries will understand? What are our problem? What we are facing in our country, right? They won't understand what we are facing. And the people also have the question that why only these 5 countries? Then India's contribution to the United Nations. India has been a member of the United Nations since it was formed in 1945. It has always stood for peace and played an important role in the UN's effort for world peace. Some of the main achievements and efforts of India are as follows. India is the member of United Nations, I have already told you all, and from the very beginning, from the year 1945, Indian armed forces have been used as peacekeeping forces in the Middle East, Cyprus and the Democratic Republic of Congo and Sudan. Now see, India's arm, like we have seen in this image, that Indian armed force here is used as peacekeeping force in Ethiopia, Africa. Here it is shown the image of Ethiopia, Africa. So these, what is contribution, what India has given to UN? So India has given its army force to as peacekeeping force. India is not a permanent member of the United Nations Security Council. However, India has been elected several times for a seat in the Security Council, for example during 1984-85 and 1991-92. India is not the permanent member, right? As we have seen those 15 members. But India is not the permanent member, even though India was given a chance to become the member, but it has not accepted yet. India played a prominent role in putting forward the concerns of developing countries at the United Nations. India has really played very important role. India is putting forward all the views and ideas. India actively opposed the policy of considering blacks as inferior to whites in South Africa. This policy was known as apartheid. Finally, due to the pressures of the United Nations and countries like India, apartheid was abolished in South Africa. India established relations with South Africa only after this. Now, India was very against this policy of blacks. So, the pressure was given on all these nations who were against these blacks. And finally, what happened? This policy was abolished, means cancelled. Many Indians are working in the United agencies. India has also received help from time to time from the agencies for its development program. Okay, so many Indians are working in the United Nations agencies, the agencies which I have told you all now. And India also receives help from these agencies time to time and to become for the development of the country, for the development programs also. So here we have completed with this chapter. If there are any doubts related to this chapter, we will definitely solve in the doubt solving session. Till then, thank you.